Welcome back to this new year 2021, and I hope it will be a great one for you all, better than the last one anyway. It really gives us a challenge, and I think for all of us. But let's dive into this copyright thingy that I've got here today for you. I think it's important to make a copyright on all your work. It's just important so that it can that metadata will tag along your photos. It will not print on the photo, but it will be in the information of the photo. Wherever you use it or whoever it use, the metadata will go along. And that's why I think it's very important. If you set it up once, then it's there. And obviously until the next year, except if you don't use a date and only your name or something, then you don't have to update it every time. But let's assume you don't have one. This is just something that I was busy working with. So when you go to the import button here, I've got my new folder 2021 update Lightroom. So say that this is the photos that I want to upload, or because I want to work on it now. On the right hand side, it says apply during import. There you can see the metadata, and it's 2020, my copyright symbol and my name. Okay, you can choose anyone. But this is the previous years, and I've got some different ones trying out just when I was learning this whole thing. If you don't have anyone, any preset of the copyright, then you can go to new, and I will show you everything now quickly. Then it's untitled preset there. You can obviously put the name in, say 2021 copyright symbol with your name. That can be the preset name. If you scroll down, there's nothing in this boxes. Don't feel overwhelmed with this. The IPTC copyright is what you need to fill in, and IPTC creator. That is the only important things that you need to fill in. But let me show you what my 2021 looks like, and I think it will make a little bit more of sense. Okay, you was supposed to press create, but we will just cancel out here for 1 second. So let's go to this metadata here and my 2020 preset. Edit, preset, I used the 2021. Can you see there's nothing here? Look at that, preset custom. Drop down the drop down arrows there. There's my 2021. You can obviously edit anyone. I will edit my 2020. Now I can see this is what I've filled in. You see it's only this part. IPTC, the copyright and the creator. At the copyright, I put in 2020 copyright symbol and my name and all rights reserved. If you want to make that copyright symbol, you can do it on your option and the letter G, and it will give the copyright symbol. If you're on a PC, it's Alt 0169. If you keep in the Alt key and press 0169, you will get this copyright symbol. But on a Mac, it's Option and G. And on copyright status, I just say the copyrighted drop down. You can say public domain or unknown, but put in copyright. Rights and usage terms. I only put there, you can put in anything there. I put in all rights reserved, no reproduction. Without that prior notice thingy, you can do whatever you want to put in there. IPTC creator, there's my name, Rustenburg. The information that you put in here is what you can, that the people can use if they find your photo somewhere and they want to contact you, maybe for some reason why they want to contact you. Doesn't matter. Your email address and your creator website. My job title, I mean, it's my own business, so I say owner or photographer or retoucher. You can put in anything you like there. I've put extra my website in here, and the source is me. This is actually the only things you need to put in, and you put in done. I did put in the first place, I select edit preset. So now that I want to edit it, I can just make that one a little one there. You see? So now I can just done here on this one there. It will ask you to save that one. I don't want to save that one because I know I still got the memory card of December 2020 that I need to download. So then I can go back when I want to do that one and I import the photos. I can go to my metadata on this site and select the 2020 copyright symbol that I've got there, the copyright message. But the other times that you download, you want to select the 2021. So I can't just update this this one. So when you say done here, it will automatically change your 2020 preset. But that's not what you want to do. Just go here on top there, okay? And you can say save current setting as new preset. Rather do it as a new one and still keep your old one. And now you can name it like 2021, my copyright symbol, but I'm on a Mac. Just quickly do this. And my name. Then I will know in the presets. Let me just create quickly. Now it's created as 2021. And now I can say done. Here on my right hand side, now you can see it's 2021 that's selected. So if I import now here, I'm not going to do it now. When I import here, it will be on the 2021 copyright symbol. Okay. So now if I go to my memory card that I still have of December left that I need to download. When I import, I will go and choose this 2020 copyright mark. Okay. And if I do the new cards from this year, then I will just go back to the 2021. The 2021 will be the default one when you exit your Lightroom. It will come up with the 2021. If you had selected the 2021 the last time and worked and exit the Lightroom, that one will be then the default one. You have to make sure to just select your 2021 copyright mark, okay? So then you check that one. Okay, then you can press the import button. Your metadata is done, and if you want something to do and print on your photos or just show your name on the photo, that is called watermarking, and that is not your metadata. So that is something totally different, and you can also make a preset for that. So if anyone wants maybe information about that, or let me make a video for you how to make a preset that you can write the name on your photo itself. Somewhere, it doesn't matter. There's an option to choose on the right hand side, in the middle, or on the left hand side, even on top, or the right hand side on top. But that is the watermarking, and that will be on displayed on your photo if you use it online or anywhere that. I did forget to mention that I'm using Lightroom CC now at this stage, and if there's anyone with the older version, it's supposed to be actually basically the same. But if there's any problems, you can contact me or ask me in the comments. I do hope that you enjoyed this tutorial, and if so, click that like button and don't forget to subscribe for more of my helping videos. I'm sure it will help someone, and I hope so anyway. I hope you liked it, and leave me a comment, and all the best for this 2021.